Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can quickly and easily create a multiple dependent drop-down list in Microsoft Excel. Let me give you a little example of what this means, because that can be confusing if you've never heard of it before, but it's actually something very simple you can create. Now, when I go over to here, you can see that there's fruit and apple. There's a drop down here. So if I drop down, you see the four different fruit that I have here. It's pulling, it's dependent upon what is right here. So if I go and choose oranges on this one, then what happens is if I go ahead and drop down on this one, it is the orange list that comes up because it was dependent upon this first one. So I could pick that. Now, if I want to see how many I have and I drop down, you can see the 73 comes up because it was dependent upon that. And if I look underneath, you can see in my quantity here, I have 73. So these were dependent upon each other. They dynamically changed based on what I chose. So that's what I want to go over today, is how to create the dependent drop-down list in Microsoft Excel. If you want to follow along today with what I'm doing with the practice sheet, just take a look down below in the description, click on it, open it up, and download it as a copy to your computer, and then you'll be able to follow along. The next thing I just want to mention is that there are many ways that you can create a multiple dependent drop-down list. I think this is one of the easiest ways to do it and quickest, but it does have its drawbacks. And as I create my drop-down list, I'm going to show you where the problems are, how I can fix it, but then I'll put out other videos too on different ways you can do this drop-down, multiple dependent drop-down list also. So the first thing what I like to do with my data, and this is my data, it's kind of just stuff I threw together and the numbers don't mean anything, just quantity down below. But I like to make a table out of this information, and it's very quick to do. The reason why I like to make a table, it allows me, if I add anything later on, it dynamically updates with those. So if I added another banana, it would automatically update my list. So that's why I'm going to make this a table at first, and I can do this by just going insert table, or as a shortcut, hit Control T and this pops open, and you can, mine does have the headers, and I'm going to hit OK. And now it's a table, and I'm just going to leave it as this formatting. I'm not going to bother turning the bottom one into a table for this example here, but I'm going to do this one. Now, the next thing what I'll need to do is actually name these list here, kind of a range, and I'm going to just kind of tell you why here. Because when we use the direct indirect function that I'm going to show you, it can pull out an address from somewhere. When we name a range, it allows us, that range becomes a place that we can refer to. So in this case, it's easy to do this. I'm going to highlight this again, and I'm going to go up to the formulas and take a look under create from selection. This is where we create names. And so it's going to be based in the top row. So it's going to create these four different regions in here named. So I'm going to hit OK. Now I want to show you where this exists. So if I click off of this and now I drop down, you can see I have table three, oranges, lemons, bananas. If I click on bananas, it takes me to this right here. So this is the kind of that named range. Now, the indirect function that we're going to use, so I'll just give a little example. I'm going to type A1 right here. If I go and start a formula just with the equal sign and start typing indirect, and here's my indirect, I'm just going to double click on this. It can go get kind of an address. I can use this right here, A1, is actually referring to up here. So if I click here and just close this up and hit enter, notice that it says fruit form. It doesn't say A1 because this, when I said indirect, this is an address to here. So I'm going to be able to do that with the list. So if I'm in a certain spot, I can go get a list to come up. So let's give this a try. The first drop-down list that we want to create is dependent upon these four headings right up here. So at this point, these don't have to be named ranges. On this case, this is just going to be a selection. So this is going to be data validation that we use. And if I go to insert here, oops, sorry, if I go to data and data validation and just click on that, you can see right here, we want to create a list. So it's going to be a drop-down list. If I go and drop down to the list one, what is the source that I want? I'm going to just click on this arrow here, and the source is going to be these four things. And I'm just going to hit enter and hit OK. Now take a look at this. I can go ahead and drop down just like, so I can drop down and everything's working right now, just like that. Now I'm going to go back. If I wanted to make any changes to this, I can go back and hit data validation, and here it is here, and I can make any changes like this. I could also, if I wanted to change it from what I wanted up here, as you can see, I'm going to hit OK. So that takes care of the first step. Now the next thing what I want to do is have a drop down based on one of the lists, the ranges that I created. So what do I need to do? I need to use data validation again. So I'm going to go to back up here, data validation, and my list. And this is where I'm going to put my function, my formula. So I'm going to put equals indirect here, just like that. And where do I want? So I could go and click on it. It automatically puts it to kind of absolute value of the dollar signs. I don't really want this because I want to be able to copy this down. So where is it going to be drawing, taking the information dependent upon what I choose? Well, it says lemons now, but I can change that. So at this point here, this is a six. So I'm just going to go and put A6 in brackets. Oops, I got to make sure I put six there and close it up, hit OK. So now, if I go and choose, let's say apples, drop down, notice I get the list of apples here. If I choose bananas, now that the dynamically changes dependent upon what I chose here, drop down, and here are all the bananas that I chose. Now the last thing what I want to do is in this example is add the amount that are down here. So what I'm going to do is just highlight everything. And I'm not going to make this a table. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the same thing what I did before with the formulas and create from selection a name. So top row, hit OK. Just like that. Notice it, if I drop down now, look at all the different ones that come up because these are all name ranges, not in a table. Now the problem is, now this is where you might not want to use this. I left this in because I knew mistakes would happen. See where it says Ladyfinger or Granny Smith? When you do these names like this, they can't have spaces in them, or they can't just be a number. So this is going to be a problem for here. So this is why you might not want to use this. And I can show kind of how you can correct this, but then it's going to change different places in here that you can't use the spaces either. So let's go here and just use our same way. We go up to data and data validation again. I'm going to drop down to my list. And at this point, so what is going to be my source? So I'm going to use the indirect again. So I'm going to type in indirect, just like that. And what's the spot I want to take it from? Well, I want to take it from B6. So I'm just going to put B6. Just like this. And notice that it's saying errors. I'm going to hit yes here. So if I go hit apples, and then I'm going to pick, I'm just going to pick Fuji and drop down 67. Well, that matches. That's fine. That's working. So that's exactly what we want to have happen. And at this point too, I can copy this down and then make different changes. So if this was bananas, and I could drop down to the bananas and 97, so that was, and that's working. Now I'm going to show you where this doesn't work. So if I'm going to go back to Apple, take a look. If I pick Granny Smith here, I can't do anything. So right away, this is the problem that I want to show you that's happening here with this, and I want to show you how you could correct it. But then again, you might want to use a different way because it could change up everything how you have it listed before, and that'd make a lot of work. Now, before I show you how to do this fix, I just want to point out how quickly changes can be made and how dynamic. See how Ladyfinger, I'm missing the last letter. I didn't notice that before. But if I go in, so the drop down, if I drop down and look for, I'm under the wrong one. So under bananas here, drop down. And it doesn't have an E. But if I go over here and just put my R in here, if I was going to drop down, notice it's fixed now. Again, if I wanted to add something new, I'll just type new, and I'll go back to bananas again, and there's new. So it updates very quickly. And that's why I wanted to point out why we'd want to use a table. It allows that dynamic to update like that. So let's fix this problem. Now, the problem is when I pick Granny Smith here, then it looks, and I said that the problem is going to be this space. So I'm going to have to make some changes in a couple of different spots. So I would need to make this because it needs to be identified, same naming here, right? So Granny Smith here and then Granny Smith here. But then I also have to make this a new name this again, and it's going to be without the space. So if I go back up to here and I'm just going to click on my formulas and just go to here, hit OK. And now if I do the drop down, I should have a Granny Smith. You notice I have two here. If I go back up to here and drop down, I have apples and a Granny Smith and drop down 64. So that fixed it. I'd have to do the same thing to Ladyfinger. It's going to be needing to be corrected in both spots here. And then I'm going to have to rename it so it gets identified as a different range, a named range that will match what they pick. So I hope that makes sense about the correcting of it. So if you're planning to set this up, thinking about your naming conventions, if it does work to do it this way, like I said, there are different ways. Let me know if this way works for you or if you need to use a different method for your multiple dependent dropdown list. I hope you like this example here today in Microsoft Excel. Let me know. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.